Massive Disney fan, yeah. Obviously, I've got the two kids. We're all big fans of Disney, yeah.
And what's the best film, in your opinion?
Toy Story 3 was pretty good, yeah. I must admit, I had a tear in my eye towards the end there, yeah. Very good.
I love your instant initial reaction. Everyone else sort of says, oh, I don't know, I can't say. You absolutely know.
Yeah. But they do it very well, yeah.
They do. Good old Disney, eh? Talk to me a bit about Enders and your love of that show.
Yeah, I've been there 7 years. Just signed a new contract, so I'm really happy about that. Lots of exciting things coming up for Max. Obviously, Tanya's gone, Joe Joyner's gone. So I have to wait and see what happens with Max. But I know they've got exciting things lined up for the rest of the year. We've got some great people coming in. And, yeah, it's, you know, it's sort of a time of change. There's quite a few people moving out and some, you know, people coming in. So it'd be great.
When you say you've signed a new contract, what does that mean? Is that for a length of time or is it until a particular storyline is unfolded?
It's for the foreseeable future, yeah. So I'm very pleased, yeah.
It's almost a permanent contract.
Yeah, well, it's been 7 years already and, yeah, I'm very happy there. And, yeah, it's a great character. I enjoy playing Max a lot. So, yeah, hopefully I'll be there for many more years to come.
And what's the storyline that you're most proud of?
Oh, there's quite a few. Probably Max and Stacey reveal, very proud of that. The stuff that we did recently with Joe Joyner, with Tanya leaving, I thought they're wonderfully written again by Simon Ashdown. But yeah, there's so many over the years, I can't think.
But EastEnders is always, it's always pushing boundaries, isn't it? It's always kind of taking new topics and controversial topics and writing storylines around them. Do you think there's something that hasn't yet been covered that could be in the future?
Oh, you got me there. I don't know. Yeah, I'll leave that to the writers to work out. But I think you're right. When they do a story over a long period of time and really research it, as we've seen with the Lauren drinking storyline, and you know, I think that when they do those storylines really well. So yeah, they're well researched, and I think they have a big impact. I think they've got a responsibility to sort of do them right. To sort of inform as well as to entertain. So, yeah, they do it.
It's a massive social impact, isn't it? And often if you take something like, I remember Doc Cotton's kind of the suicide story, and there are so many people who can then call in to helplines and...
No, I think they can really raise awareness. I mean, it's such a huge show. So that I think, when they do it really well. I'm very, very, very proud of the way that EastEnders does it, yeah.
So you're very much committed to EastEnders. Is there anything else that you then want to do in your career alongside or after?
Who's to say? Yeah, at the moment I'm just sort of committed on being at EastEnders and very happy there. So yeah, who knows what the future holds? But at the moment, it's all Wolford for me.
And how is juggling being a dad and your career?
I think it's like any working parent. You know, it's always a delicate balancing act. But hopefully on that show, I've got a good balance at the moment. So it works incredibly well.